In this video, we'll take a look at AJA Kumo routers and how you can take salvos from Skahoy panels, like the Rack Fly Trio, which is a new 72 button panel from Skahoy that will work perfectly with any router systems. In fact, in this case, we have so many buttons on the panel that we had difficulties finding a good use for the last block of 18 buttons on the far right of the panel, but that's a positive problem. So I trust that you understand this panel is really, really versatile. And even if you had more sources than 18 or 16, like in this case, you could apply a shift key to change between new banks of buttons, basically. The configuration we did today, I'll just go through the basics of it. And on the upper row, I select the output. So you see the output can be selected by pressing a button. I also have labels of the output, and those labels are coming from the AJA Kumo router. So in the typical Skahoy style, we pull all the information we can out of the external units. I will give you an example, because if you will look at the AJA Kumo router interface here, I can change the label of this source. And let's say that this is a camera. Okay, I apply, and you'll see the label is instantly updated over here. As I now change this label, it also appears on some of the other controllers, which we'll get back to in a moment. But labels pulled out of the Kumo router, of course they are, and we can select them on the upper row. And then as I press buttons on the middle row, I assign a source to the selected output. I'll now assign this source, and I can go on doing that all day. That is what a crosspoint router panel is doing for you in its essence. We can see this happening if we go to the home screen here and we look at the destination camera number one. You can see that these sources are going to change. Let me see. Destination here. So as I'm changing my source right here, I'm confused. I need to go to source number seven, the one that I'm selecting here. And there you see, as I'm changing the sources here, you see this is reflected in the web interface. So it's actually happening on the router. So far, so good. I want to show you how you can select multiple sources. So Skahoy style, press and hold the key, and then you are adding sources to your bank of selected, you're adding outputs to your bank of selected outputs. So what happens now is when I press this button, that source is going to be routed to those three outputs on the router over here. Let's check if this is the case. We go to this output, we see number nine, this output five is number nine as well. And the last one was seven, also source number nine. But if I check source number eight, like this one, you see this is the source router to that one. So you can pull your outputs together. And even on this panel, I put in a completely new feature we just made, which is called memory group presets. And the memory group is essentially what we use when we assign or select multiple outputs here. So let me select two outputs here, and then I press and hold this key. It's now storing the configuration of the output. So what I'm going to do is to select another set of outputs over here by pressing and holding the key. So those four outputs, and then I press and hold and put them into preset bank number two. Now notice what happens when I press number one. I recall those two being selected. I press now number two, and I recall those four selected. This is not an AJA Kumo router feature. This is a Skahoy panel feature, and how we can work with the internal registers we use to build up these types of configurations. So we'll be looking at salvos as the next thing. And to do that, I will make a firmware upgrade. So I'll just circle back over to my Skahoy firmware updater here. And first, before I do that, I need to make sure that I'm connected with my USB cable. So this is how you do firmware upgrades on your Skahoy panel. You connect the USB. Then in the firmware updater we look at here, I can now go to my online environment, where you can see that I currently have a user configuration, which is what I did to set this one up. So basically this configuration, if we look at in from the advanced view, what I did, you can see on the buttons down here, I selected take salvo as the action that I assigned to these buttons, and we'll now do a firmware upgrade to see this feature working on the panel. So I'll press update firmware from master. And there we go. Now the firmware has been updated. If you want to check if everything went fine, you can always go to the serial monitor. This will give you confidence that the correct IP addresses are picked up with the panel and so on. For instance, in this case, we set it up with an DHCP address. So we want to see in the serial monitor that it actually got that address from the DHCP server. And you see all the routes were read out of the AJ Kumo. What I was talking about with the IP addresses is shown right here. So this is nice that you can check the IP addresses are right. But now let's go and look at the salvo. So first, I want to show you what a salvo is. And we go to the AJ Kumo interface. We go to the salvo tab. And here, if I press button number one for salvo number one, I can load the selected salvo. So the selected salvo is that this routing, input one to output one, input two to output two, input three to output three, will be installed on the Kumo router when I take this salvo. If I look at salvo number two, we can load this one in. You see it's basically opposite, and then it is including more outputs. And then if I load the current route, you can see this is the mess that we have currently set up by selecting outputs and inputs as we want. So now when I press button number one, we should see that the first three outputs will be aligned like we saw for salvo number one. So let's press it, and then we load the current routes, and you see nicely those three inputs output combinations are now reloaded. Let's take salvo number two, and when I do that and I load the routes, then look at the interface, and you see the whole Kumo router, including sources from 4 up to 16, are now installed on the Kumo router by taking the salvo using the Skahoy panel. So this is a power walkthrough of the features of the RackFly Trio, which is our new 72-button rack control panel. You can use it for Kumo routers, anything really that you can do with a Skahoy controller. But I have more for you. I have also the QuickPad. So in this case, this little guy, and let's have a close-up shot of this one. Really beautiful, nice little looking controller. You see it, it is really, 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 really nice. You should hold it. I hope one day that we'll see each other at a trade show. You'll have a chance to work with it directly, or you could just purchase it, of course. Now, on this one, I gave an example of how router control is not only reserved for rack panels in the server room, it's also something you can bring out to your end users in user-friendly forms if you want. So this panel has been configured as an example with features which will route input number one, two, and three, and so forth to output number one. Let's go to the home configuration of the Kumo router so we can follow it on screen here. And if we select the destination number one, you see that these changes are in fact happening. So far this good. Now, I also want to show you another new feature for the Kumo router, which is route output to output. And that's assigned to the final button on the panel, which I decided to paint in a blue color to make sure that you didn't mistake it for the function of the first five. Now, again, it's just an example. I just want to show you that sometimes it is useful to have a button which will say whatever is routed to output number one should also be routed to output number two in case I press this button. And that's in fact what's happening right here. So notice how I'm changing when I'm changing here. This button over here will tell you the source that is currently selected for output number one is the source that will be routed to output number two if you press the button. And so let's pick C90, for instance. No, wait, that's a bad example because it was already selected. Now I select input number three, CX350. And then if I go to output number two over here, you can see currently it's routed. It has input number two routed to it, but I now press this button and it will route input number three to output number two because input number three is what is currently on output number one. But if I select the BMD input source for output number one, you see it is changing here. And as I'm pressing it again, it's going to make that route. I also did other things up here. Actually, the top row of buttons, if you turn this knob, you're changing between four different levels of shift keys, which will allow you to route this input to the output selected over here. So basically, I made this knob an output selector, and the output is shown in the title of the display. So there you have now monitor 10, which is, let me see if we can find this output right here. And my shift level will now give me access to this source, which is, one of the ones we find here. Let's take, so when I press this button, you'll see that it's changing to input number nine. And input number 12, if I want, I could change this one. So I basically have different banks I can go through. So that's a quick pad. I would say this is not a very user-friendly configuration because I made it to show how many powerful features we can pack into a product like this one. And the way you do it is by means of configuration. So on this page, you could basically see the configuration I made. You can see if you press this button, how I have, depending on the which shift level I'm on, selected by this knob, you can see that it's going to route input number 1, number 5, number 9, or number 13 to the output selected in memory bank AA. And memory bank AA was selected by knob number knob A, which selects which output you want to route to, putting it into memory AA. It is circling through output number 1 up to 16. This is what that means. And likewise, you can look at these down here. It is just fixed routings, input number 1 to output number 1, input number 2 to output number 1. And then finally, if you go to button number 6, which had the new feature output to output, it will take the input currently routed to output number 1 and let you route that to output number 2. So that's just, there you can see how we have programmed the panel by configuration using a web interface. The final thing I have for you is how you can connect a GPI box to your AJA Kumo router. And that's very popular if you have RCPs where you want the preview button to route the panel. And if you have a SCARHOI RCP, you don't need this because the SCARHOI RCPs can connect directly to the AJA Kumo router. But if you had legacy RCPs, or if you want to use the hold group feature on this one, you can do that. So the hold group feature is a special feature we have developed, which will facilitate workflows known to shaders. That workflow is sometimes that you press a joystick, we call it joystick override, and then you press another joystick, and then when you release this one, you want to, let me see. Okay, you press this one first, so that's routed to the screen. Then you press a second joystick, and that's routed to the screen. But then you release this one, and when you press that one again, you now want this one routed to the screen. And then when you release both of them, you want them to fall back to the original source. So that kind of workflows can allow you to do basically like this, to compare two camera sources if you want. But you need, when you release everything, to go back to the original. And that's done by something we call hold groups, which is like a queuing system, putting the routed sources, I think up to 5, into a queue that will fall back through when you release all the joysticks. And that can be done by a GPI box. And the GPI box has inputs and outputs. So this is what the Ethernet GPI link does for you. Now, in these buttons are basically, this board is just one that I used to simulate. And I set it up so that these LEDs will light up when the first sources on the Kumo router is, if you look at input number 1, we should now be able to see this routing happening. So, and notice, as I promised, if we go and look at the configuration, we have a special feature called hold group in use here. It means that for as long as I hold the trigger down, like if you press the preview button on your RCP, it will keep that source, but then it will fall back to a defined previous source when I release it again. And that's exactly what you see happening. Again, if we go back to the interface here, notice how if I trigger the first one here, it is routing a source to the first output. It's also indicated by the LED, but you see it on the interface. And now I press another trigger here, and you see number 2 is selected, but when I release this one, it's falling back to number 1. So as I'm repeatedly pressing number 2, it's falling back to the previous one I'm still holding. But if I release the first one here and then release it, then it's falling back to the original source. Maybe a little bit confusing, but the main point is that regardless of whether you want to have a rack panel, which is for your server room, or your OB truck, or if you want a user-friendly quick pad that will bring control of routers right in the hand of your end users, or if you want a GPI box, SCARHOI has it. So any of these products, any other of our products, will work with AJA Kumo routers.